Roger Mason this morning from Antipa Minerals. Roger, morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you doing?
Yeah, really good, Roger. Good to see you. Big update yesterday, the discovery here of Geo-01. Tell us a bit more about it.
Andrew, look, we're pretty pumped to deliver these discovery intersections, you know, of near-surface high-grade gold mineralisation at Geo-01. We had standout discovery intersections, including 68 metres at 1.4 grams per tonne, including 36 at 2.6 grams per tonne gold. And this drill hole pretty much ended in mineralisation. We also had 48 metres at 1.3 grams per tonne gold, including 28 metres at 2.2 grams per tonne gold. And this drill hole actually ended in mineralisation. So more to come from that one. Geo-01 is only 1.3 kilometres southeast of our 1.5 million ounce Minyari resource. And these discovery intersections are as good as you know, some of Minyari's better drill results.
Well, how big could this high-grade gold mineralisation be?
Well, Andrew, look, it's still relatively early days for our evaluation of Geo-01. Initially, we generated a large soil anomaly, which we backed up with an air core anomaly measuring 700 metres by 400 metres. And now our first pass, very broad-spaced RC drilling, has delivered these exciting results. In terms of size of the prize, look, we've intersected thick, high-grade gold mineralisation in two RC holes 100 metres apart on the same drill section, with mineralisation basically commencing from surface under just a few metres of sand cover, and both these holes pretty much ending in mineralisation at depths of, you know, up to 150 metres below the surface. So this first pass RC, the drill sections are a long way apart. The spacing's about 100 metres, and we've intersected encouraging zones of gold mineralisation variously across a 770 metre by 450 metre footprint. But as you know, is always the case, the continuity of the higher grade mineralisation will ultimately be the key to unlocking significant economic scale. But you know, look, we're certainly off to a fantastic start at Geo-01.
Well, how might this impact the development opportunity at Minyari Dome?
Oh, look, good question, Andrew. So earlier this year, we made the decision to pause the Minyari Dome pre-feasibility study. And that was on the basis that several highly prospective targets, you know, all within 1.5 kilometres of Minyari, had potential to deliver a material increase to the resource and extend the mine life of the project development opportunity past 10 years. Achieving this quantum of mine life extension, particularly with an increased component of open pit production, significantly boosts the project economics. So look, if we can get some meat on the Geo-01 discovery bones, this could deliver that material open pit amenable maiden resource which we're looking for to feed into a boosted pre-feasibility study.
Well, in terms of tracking down more meat to put on the bone, what are the follow-up plans?
Andrew, look, we're currently completing our review of the Geo-01 first pass RC data in conjunction with other geophysical and geological information. And we're also awaiting the results for the remainder of the Phase 1 RC drill program, which tested a number of other Minyari Dome targets. So we're not quite ready to finalise our Phase 2 drilling plan just yet. However, it's very obvious that Geo-01 requires follow-up infill and deeper RC drilling, and possibly some diamond core to provide detailed feedback on things like mineralisation geometry, structural controls and continuity. Timing-wise, look, we're very keen to commence our Phase 2 drill program as soon as possible this quarter.
You reckon there's scope, Roger, for further potential discoveries here this year?
Look, Andrew, prior to the end of this year, we will be systematically testing many high-potential Havieron, Nifty, Minyari and Winu analog targets across all four of our Patterson projects. Apart from the drilling which Antipa will complete on its 100% owned 900 square kilometre Minyari Dome project, our major partners, Rio Tinto, IGO, and Newcrest, are planning to complete further 13,000 metres of drilling as part of their combined $8.6 million exploration spend across our three partner projects, which cover a further 4,200 square kilometres of, you know, hugely prospective Paterson Province ground, providing, you know, additional outstanding non-dilutive upside leverage to Antipa shareholders. Look, my list of most exciting targets for potential greenfield gold copper discoveries includes, you know, GO01, obviously, PPGrav02, where historic broad-spaced rab holes intersected gold mineralization under shallow cover along the edge of this target, which has characteristics very similar to Havieron and, you know, really looks like a discovery in the waiting room. We have our Tetris target, which put simply is a Havieron doppelganger, and we're setting up to start this drilling as soon as possible. We have several Nifty and Havieron analog targets at Pac-Man, where we've been completing further detailed geophysical surveys to fine-tune several drill targets there. And we also have two exciting Havieron analog targets not far from Rio Tinto's Tier 1 8 million ounce gold and 3 million tonne copper Winu development project. So investors, you know, they're encouraged to watch this Antipa space during a very busy discovery-focused second half of this year.
Yeah, really good to see you. Roger, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Cheers, bye.